Tennessee added some much-needed depth at the cornerback position by signing Janoris Jenkins and drafting Caleb Farley, but Jenkins, Farley, and Fulton are really meant to play on the outside, and they were in need of a pure slot cornerback, which is exactly what they got in Elijah Molden. If we look at the positional alignment for Tennessee's other corners, you see that ideally they all play over 90% on the outside. Fulton played a lot in the slot his rookie season because Tennessee didn't have a true slot guy for a lot of the year, but I expect him to move outside more this year. And in 2019, Elijah Molden played in the slot 97% of the time, so he should step into that role with no problem. In 2020, Washington moved him to safety, not because he struggled in the slot or anything, just because they didn't have anyone else to play there. I don't think he's a safety at the next level, but it is nice that he's comfortable playing multiple positions. Here's some statistics for Elijah Molden, and keep in mind he only played 4 games in 2020, but you can see he graded out really well for PFF, and he made a ton of plays on the ball. Even though he's only 5'9", Molden is about as tough as they come when defending the run. He willingly takes on blocks and has no hesitation when he's pursuing the ball carrier. On this play, Washington State runs a wide receiver screen with 2 lead blockers, and the goal is to force Molden into making a decision in either direction. If Molden goes outside, the receiver will cut inside, and if Molden goes inside against the blocker's leverage, the receiver will run outside. The only way to properly defend this is to attack the block head-on, which is exactly what Elijah Molden does. He still shades his trajectory to the outside because he has linebacker help on the inside, but instead of running around the block, he runs through it and secures the tackle. Molden has a great understanding of leverage and avoiding blocks whenever he needs to defend screens or runs to the outside. Washington State's going to run a tunnel screen here, and Washington's in man coverage, so the outside receiver is the target of the screen, and the slot receiver runs a quick out with the purpose of drawing Elijah Molden outside and giving the left tackle an easier blocking angle. But when Molden sees the tackle's movement and the receiver's route, he immediately breaks upfield. A 5'9 slot corner isn't going to be able to take on a block from a tackle, so it's critical that he beats him to the spot. With only 22 missed tackles on 172 attempts, Molden is a very secure tackler, and he's great at moving in space to navigate blocks. In terms of defending the run and stopping quick passes, I think Molden has the potential to give Tennessee what they had in Logan Ryan a few years ago. Molden also has great instincts and play recognition and zone coverage as well. Here Washington's in cover 3 with Molden pattern matching the number 2 receiver, unless the number 1 receiver runs a hitch, in which case the outside corner makes a smash call and he passes his route off to Molden. The number 1 receiver fakes a hitch, which Molden picks up, but then the receiver breaks vertically, so Molden continues to extend his depth and read the quarterback's eyes, preparing to break on the ball if the receiver cuts outside. Once he notices the back running into the shallow zone that Molden was originally responsible for, he accelerates towards him and makes the stop. He's not just disciplined and always in the right spot, he has the athleticism and playmaking ability to bait quarterbacks into making poor decisions. On this interception, USC's running an RPO, and Molden just reads Keaton Slovis' eyes and makes an interception from zone coverage. And then he almost gets Slovis for another interception later in the game, but he can't come down with the football. Washington's rolling into cover 3 out of 2 high, and Molden works 2-1, making sure that he stays outside of the number 2 receiver, and then moving to make a play on the number 1's in-breaking route. In man coverage, Molden uses the sideline really well, and he has really good hip fluidity when transitioning out of press coverage. This makes him really effective at defending routes when the receiver releases outside. Molden played a lot of what's called catch man from the slot, which you can think of as sort of a middle ground between press and off coverage. In catch man, the defensive back will give about 4 to 7 yards of cushion pre-snap, but he'll wait for the receiver to eat up that cushion before jamming them. Catch man can make for more effective route disruption because the offense might not be expecting a jam and it can throw off their timing. One of the issues with catch technique is that the chuck zone is only 5 yards past the line of scrimmage. If you jam a receiver past the chuck zone, you'll get called for illegal contact, so it's important that the defensive back's first jam is effective. Another vulnerability of catch coverage is that the receivers allowed a few interrupted steps to build up speed, so it's even more important for the corner to maintain active feet. Molden has good speed for a slot corner, and he does a really good job of using his hands downfield without drawing a penalty. A lot of people think you're not supposed to make any contact down the field, but every good corner in the NFL is super aggressive with their hands, they just don't grab and pull on the jersey. And then Molden's ability to turn his hips once the receiver releases outside is insanely good. This creates such a small transition period between jamming and running with the receiver. Molden's length, or lack thereof, is the primary issue that you see in man-to-man, and this issue shows up at the catch point and on inside releases. On this rep against Arizona, Molden really does everything pretty well. He makes early contact, keeps his feet active and square, and he hugs the receiver's outside shoulder, but he doesn't have the length to shield him from the ball. And there's several plays like this one where he's really in good position throughout every phase of the route, but the receiver wins the contested catch. In general, Elijah Molden has great ball skills, so he still wins at the catch point more often than he loses, but when he does lose, you see the lack of length being a bit of an issue. And if he struggles anywhere in the NFL, I expect it to be against bigger slot receivers. This is one of several reasons that you'll rarely hear me criticize a team for investing draft capital at cornerback. Because nickel defense is the new base, slot corner is legitimately a starting position in the NFL, and cornerback is the second most injury-prone position. Tennessee now has four starting caliber corners whose versatility I expect them to take advantage of. On December 19th, Tennessee plays Pittsburgh, whose starting slot receiver is Juju Smith-Schuster, and it wouldn't surprise me if Tennessee had Christian Fulton cover him since he played a lot of slot last season. But against more traditional slot receivers like Jamison Crowder or whatever random dude Bill Belichick finds, Molden can cover them and Fulton can return outside. Thanks for watching. If you enjoy my film breakdowns, consider subscribing. Also follow me on Twitter and I'll put the link on the screen.